wanted to share a little bit about what I've learned so far and why I'm doing this. So the giving year was originally created, so I know puppies want to be there too. Oh yes. So the giving year was created really to see what happens when we go out with a committed action every day for 365 days of gratitude and appreciating people. And not just that in its own, but just the fact of doing it, to actually commit to it and then follow through in itself is an accomplishment that I don't even know what's gonna come from it at all. But to be on the 38th day, and when I go in on the website now and I see all those videos that I've made, it's almost like I don't even realize that I've made them all. And it's building. It's like it's building something that is just getting bigger and bigger, and I don't even really know what it is. But all I know is that there's a lot of love, and there's a lot of gratitude, and there's a lot of joy, and I'm spending most of my time not thinking too much of the outcome, and instead being in the moment. And you know, the changes I've gone through in the last year, and especially even since just this given year started, is I have very few moments of doubt, fear, distrust. I trust you for sure. And I know, honey, I know. It's so exciting to feel all this love. I get it. I totally get it. I know. We can make out a little bit later, okay? All right. So, one more. having an action every day is really keeping me focused and centered, and it's keeping me in the moment, because I can't think about what's going to happen tomorrow because I'm focused on what's going on today. And when I let go of all of it, it just sort of folds through, and it just works out and it flows. And it's showing up in other areas of my life where I'm seeing that I'm just really allowing it to be whatever it is in the moment. So I've decided, you know, I say yes to life, meaning that if things come up in a day and I might not really be up for it, or someone invites me to dinner or lunch or to do something, I normally, you know, would be hesitant or try to figure out what I'm gonna do, why not, or, you know, what have you. And now I just usually say yes, and knowing that if I'm not supposed to do it, something will come up where I won't do it. So by saying yes, I'm allowing the universe to really move me forward every day. And it's just been an amazing trip, journey. And the other thing that I've really learned and benefited from is to actually, the fact that I choose to document this year. Because, you know, I could have done this giving year and just doing it and, you know, see what happens, but the fact that I'm documenting it on YouTube and the times I don't have video, I write about it on my website, has really given me a different view of myself. Actually, let's see how to put this. By seeing the feedback of myself on camera and what's going on and editing and being so like hands-on involved in this, and watching what's going on, and the other day I even watched like video 1 through, you know, 37, because I wanted to sort of remember what's been going on, because I've been so in the moment that I don't even know what happened in the past. So it's great feedback for me to see where I'm at. And I also realized that I've been wrong about what I thought about myself. So I've been thinking that I mess up, or that I don't speak clearly, or that I hesitate, or that I use dumb words because I'm Swedish, like all these filters inside of me. And then when I'm after 38 days of doing this videotaping and usually getting it on the first shot, and then listening to myself and watching myself on video and seeing that, you know what, I don't mess up that much, like, and if I do, who cares, like it doesn't really matter. And it's allowing me to build more confidence, and it's also allowing me to realize that, you know, a lot of times we have a way of looking at ourselves that is completely distorted, and you know, I know we know that, but like I would suggest that if someone like had a distorted body image, to film themselves every day for like at least 40 days. And in doing something with their body to change the way that they see it. I think it's been a tremendous eye-opener for me. And then, you know, I get to take the stuff that I see maybe doesn't work so well for me and different ways of being that might not serve me and shift them and change them and practice and be in front of the camera and be comfortable in front of the camera. A year ago, I wouldn't even be comfortable in front of the camera. And here I am just like, someone brings a camera in my face and it's no big deal, which is also why I was able to do the news thing in Florida a few weeks ago and actually be on the news. I wasn't even nervous. Like, I wasn't even thinking about the fact that I was going to be on the news or on the camera, or people were going to see me. And that's only because of this. So this is really, really a helpful tool to get to be comfortable with who I am. So that's a big thing. Now, the other thing that's huge is to be out there and see people smile and see how they react when I appreciate them for something that they did. Because a lot of times we're all on automatic and we're pretty unconscious of what's going on. And when someone's automatic is to actually be, you know, generous or helpful or loving, and they get appreciated for it, it lights them up. Because one, they're not doing it for credit, you know, in the first place. And two, I think that they just, you know, they forget that people really appreciate them. And so I've seen a lot of that, and it's helped me look at people differently. The other thing is for me, I've broken through a lot of filters that I've had about going up to people and talking to people randomly. And because I would decide already what would happen. So like, for instance, I was at the poker table the other day and I actually gave a token and I asked, and I wanted to ask if I could film there. And my old filter would be, there's no way that they will let me film at a poker table at a casino in Vegas. Like, hello? And so I wasn't gonna ask. But because of what I've been doing and sort of putting myself out there, I just asked. And the woman goes, sure. And so I'm finding a lot of things that I had made up about life and about how things are supposed to be or how things were or are wrong. And so, hey everybody, this is Jo Englesson saying that she's wrong. It's a big moment right here. So, damn, I didn't know I was gonna come that far. Anyway, so it's just, it's a journey.